Yes. So now we have to move through the measures adopted by the government to reduce unemployment. In that, first one is Swarna Jayanti Gram Rozgar Yojana, that is SGSY. So this was implemented in April 1999 and it replaced IRDP and TRY-SEN, that is Self-Employment Rural Youth Program. And the main agenda of the program was to ensure the small enterprises were organized as individual enterprises and to give more assistance to the self-help groups. Okay, so in 2011-12, SGSY scheme was restructured into National Rural Livelihood Mission, that is NRLM. Now, so you don't have SGSY now, instead of that you have NRLM, that is National Rural Livelihood Mission. Next one is National Rural Livelihood Mission, that is this scheme is also known as Ajivika. And this was actually this came existence in 2011-12 replacing the SGSY, and this program now it's renamed into Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana. And next one is Sampurna Grameen Rozgar Yojana, SGRY. It was implemented on 1st September 2001. And this main objective of the mission was to provide employment opportunities to surplus workers, to focus on the development of regional, economical and social conditions, to focus on the development of infrastructure, and to provide the Yojana had a set of creating 100 crore man days for labor. That is, it was actually a starting up of MGNREGA, that is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, by the government to give 100 days of work for the workers. Next is Pradhana Mantri Gramodaya Yojana, that is PGY, launched in 2001. Five main important areas were health, primary education, drinking water, housing and roads. And also they incorporated three projects, that is Pradhana Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, Pradhana Mantri Grameen Awas Yojana and Pradhana Mantri Grameen Drinking Water Yojana. So they incorporated or they constituted three projects in that. So that was a collection of three projects inside a single project. Then Jayaprakash Rozgar Guarantee Yojana, that is JPRGY. The scheme seeks to provide guaranteed employment in most backward districts of the country. See, we have already discussed, you have backward regions more, right? So we have to discuss on, like, we have to give more importance to the backward regions. So to give more backward, emphasis on the backward region, there was a program named Jayaprakash Rozgar Guarantee Yojana. Next is Swarna Jayanti Shari Rozgar Yojana, launched on December 1, 1997, and the Prime Minister Nehru Rozgar Yojana and Prime Minister's Integrated Urban Poverty Eradication Program have been merged with this Yojana. And also the objective is to provide self-employment or wage employment to urban unemployed or underemployed persons. So it includes urban self-employment program and urban wage employment program. So wage employment program means daily wage program. Okay. So the next is Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana. Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana is PMRY implemented, the scheme is for providing employment to the educated unemployed. See, you have two types of unemployed, that is educated unemployed and uneducated unemployed. Okay, educated means you have qualifications but you are not able to find a job. Unemployed unemployment means you don't have proper qualifications to go for that job. That is why you are not able to find a job. So here it has mainly considered the educated unemployed, and it provides loan up to 1 lakh for opening up enterprise activities. Then comes development of small and cottage industries. Small scale industries and cottage industries. Now if you look through, the government is giving more emphasis on MSMEs, that is micro, small, medium enterprises. Okay, so the government has been developing small and cottage industries with a view to remove poverty and unemployment through the spread of cottage and small scale industries. Next, minimum needs program. To raise the standard of living of the poor, minimum needs program was launched in the 5th 5-year plan. and this program what you can say, this program covers primary education, adult education, rural health, rural water supply, rural roads, rural electrification, rural housing and ecological improvement of urban slums. So these are the problem, these are the areas which minimum needs program constituted. Next, 20-point program. 20-point program was implemented in on 14th January 1982, and it includes increase in this program is having 20 areas to cover. That is why it is called 20-point program. That is, I am reading out the 20 things, that is 20 points. First one is increase in irrigation capacity, increase the production of pulses and oil seeds, extension of integrated rural development program and national rural employment program, fixation of ceiling of household land holdings, minimum wages to agricultural workers, rehabilitation of bonded labor, expansion of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe program, drinking water in villages, provision of houses in rural areas, improvement of slum areas, development of power capacity, development of forest and gobar gas, like that it will go on. So I'll post the 20 points to you. Next comes the MGNREG, that is one of the major program implemented by the government as for till now, that is MGNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. It was implemented with the view to give 100 days work to the people, that is minimum period of 100 days. So they will be given 100 days of wages so that they can earn their livelihood. Then Micro Units Development Refinance Agency Bank, that is Mudra Bank. As I told you, it is a very recent development. It will provide loans up to 10 lakhs to the people. So that government has set up a Mudra Bank in 2015. Its objective is to meet credit needs of micro enterprises and self-employed persons. So they give up loan up to rupees 10 lakh. Okay. So these are the programs that is put forwarded by the government to eradicate poverty. Now we have to look through the critical assessments of these policies. How far they have guaranteed success, or what are the limitations of these programs. So we'll be looking through that in the next video. Poverty alleviation programs, a critical assessment. Okay.